Thomas, and I'm a data and applied scientist on the Azure data team working on SQL. And I'm joined today by my colleague.
I'm Jeroen de Heerdt, and I'm a program manager in the Azure data team too.
And we're excited to have you all today. And today, Jeroen's going to talk to us a little bit about Hyperscale. What are you going to go through today?
Well, Hyperscale is a new service tier for Azure SQL that we just introduced in May. And today I'm going to show how to migrate a database from Azure SQL, like regular Azure SQL, to Hyperscale.
Cool. Awesome. So what do you got there?
So, you know, the way this works, I'm in the Azure portal here. Let me zoom in a little bit. So I'm in the Azure portal. I have a standard SQL database here, a very simple one. It's general purpose pricing tier, nothing special. And I'll take this database and migrate it to Hyperscale, right? So in order to do that, what I do is I click here, I go to configure. And on configure, I can see that my database is currently in general purpose. And I can change that by going to Hyperscale over here on the right. And then I can make some configuration changes. I can choose, for example, the amount of vCores that I want or the amount of read-only replicas that I need. So yeah, that's basically, you know, the form that I get, right?
Jeroen, what is that little warning sign we're getting?
Yeah, that's a good one. Good catch. That warning sign is actually about notifying you that this is a one-way street you're entering, right? So there's no way, once you migrated your standard database to Hyperscale, there's no way to go back at this moment, right? So this is brand new. This might change in the future, but for now, this notice is here to tell you, be warned, right? You cannot go back after you went to Hyperscale.
So when I'm testing and stuff, should I use a copy?
Yeah, I would definitely just take a copy. It's very easy to take a copy of any database in Azure. So once you have it, click copy and migrate to Hyperscale on the copy. And then once you're happy with how everything works, you can then change the connection string in your application to point to this new Hyperscale version.
Yeah. Awesome.
Yep.
Cool. Thanks.
So what I'll do is I'll click here on I understand to, you know, let the portal know that I read the notice and I understand what the issue is or what I'm getting myself into. And then I'll have to choose the compute generation. So I'll always go with the latest Gen 5. And I can change the vCores, the virtual cores, the amount of replicas that I want, and I'll click apply. And then what will happen is that the database is now migrating to Hyperscale.
And that's it?
That's it. It's so easy.
Oh, wow. So what types of use cases would I want to, or would I want to move to Hyperscale while we're letting it switch over?
Sure. So, the biggest reason is actually scale, right? So either scale in terms of storage or scale in terms of query performance, right? So Azure SQL itself has approximately 4 terabyte file size limit. If you have a database larger than that, what do you do? Mm. Well, Hyperscale is your answer. So if you have, let's say, I don't know, a 40 terabyte database, a 40 terabyte data warehouse or 40 terabyte whatever database, Hyperscale can then host that database for you. And then with the read-only replicas, you get even more query performance all over all of that massive data. So those are the two main reasons to migrate to Hyperscale.
And is there a certain number of read-only replicas that I get with Hyperscale, or can I configure it?
You can configure it. It's between 0 to 4. So you can choose. I think by default it goes to 1, but you can dial it back to 0 if you don't want any read-only replicas. You can change it later as well. You can up the vCores. You can change or lower the number of replicas. So those two settings you can change after deployment.
Yep. Awesome. Cool.
So
hopefully that was useful for you all. Thanks for joining us today.
Sure.
And if you're interested in Hyperscale, feel free to leave us a like, subscribe to our channel, even leave us a comment on what you're most excited about Hyperscale. And tune in next time. Thank you.